for them all. A day to laugh, a day to learn, a day for all the creatures great and small.
You at the zoo. And now I have a special friend to introduce to you. He cares for all the animals, each and every one. He knows exactly what they eat. His work is never done. He feeds the tigers and the birds, all critters wild and tame. Why, he's the keeper of the zoo, and Rodney is his name.
Hi, kids.
Hi, Rodney.
It's so good to meet you, and welcome to the zoo. Now, what would you like to see first? I've got an idea. Let's start right here, where we are. This'll be our beginning, and who knows where we'll end. God's made so many animals to see that we'll just make today a celebration of God's creation. Primate exhibit, watching the primates, which of course is just another name for...
monkeys!
That's right! And there are so many different kinds. Some live on the ground, while others live up in the trees and never come down.
Hey, Rodney, I once saw a picture with three monkeys. One had its hands over its ears, the next one had its hands over its eyes, and the last one had its hands over its mouth. What does that mean?
That means hear no evil, see no evil, speak no evil. And that's a good thing to remember, because it's an important lesson that God wants for all of us to learn.
Hear no evil.
Be
I wish you all could see yourselves, for now I know it's true. What one monkey sees and hears, another one will do. And I just wonder what they think when they look out at you. I believe the animals think you're funny, too.
Now that's a thought. Hey, kids, what if we lived in the zoo and all the animals came to see us?
Yeah!
What kind of animal would you like to be? What if on one wacky kind of day everything worked in a backwards way? We were the ones the critters came to see, and the critters were the ones who were running free. Out of all the critters in the zoo, which of the critters would be you?
I'd be a fish and swish all around, whirling through water, making fishy sounds. That's what I'd say if I could be a fish for just one.
What are you all talking about?
How different all the animals are. The zebras have those funny stripes and are from Africa.
And those llamas with their woolly fur come from way down in South America.
And how about those panda bears? They're from way over in China. It really is amazing, isn't it? And God is able to care for them all. For instance, did you know that the reason panda bears live in China is because they eat bamboo? And bamboo grows in China. And zebras love it in Africa because they can spend their days munching on the delicious grasses that grow there. Just think, God put all the animals exactly where they need to be.
Water, on the land, in the snow, or on the sand, all part of God's creation, just the way God planned.
After seeing some of the animals here at the zoo, sometimes it's hard to understand just why God made them look the way some of them do.
Yeah, those snakes have scary eyes.
And why do those rhinos have those funny horns on their noses?
And what about those big elephant ears? Why did God make those?
Well, God had his reasons for all the eyes and all the ears and even all the noses that he made for the animals. Even the ones he made for you and me. Come to think of it, how many kinds have we seen today? Do you remember?
While strolling through the zoo one day,
are called laughing hyenas.
Well, what are they laughing at? What's so funny?
Maybe they're looking at us. I'm only kidding. They're not really laughing at all. It's just the sound they make when several of them get together and get excited.
Hey, I've got a joke. Why did the kid cross the playground? To get to the other slide. Well, at least they think it's funny.
Giraffe know when to feed her baby?
And how does the mama rhinoceros know to watch her baby so closely while it's sleeping?
Well, the mothers watch over their babies, you see, like God watches over you and me. It doesn't matter, night or day. Mom loves her baby. God made her that way.
Are there more letters in the alphabet than there are animals in the zoo?
There are lots more animals at the zoo than letters in the alphabet. Right, Mother Goose?
Oh, yes, my dear. It's oh so true. There are hundreds of animals living in the zoo. But speaking of the alphabet, I think I have a game. For every letter, A to Z, let's think of an animal name. Alphabet. It's a dandy, delightful duet. When you hear me say a letter from the ABCs, answer with the name of an animal, if you please. Now get on your mark, get ready, get set. Here comes the animal, alphabet.
you?
Walrus.
A giraffe.
Giraffe?
Giraffe doesn't start with an X.
Sure it does. If it's an extra tall giraffe.
One.
Was made, God's important plans were laid. He didn't make just you and me, but all the animals that we see. Some that jump, and some that fly, and some so strange we just ask why. For all the animals that amaze, let's give to God all our praise.
Along with those huge hippos, too.
But how did he feed them all? And where did they all sleep?
Maybe Noah made them a big bunk bed. Hippos on the bottom and giraffes on top. I really don't know how he fed them or where they all slept. But I do know that I'm glad Noah did what God told him to do. If he hadn't, I wouldn't have all these animals to take care of. I'm sure glad Noah did his job.
To build a boat that is big enough, God is deep.
sign say?
It says endangered species.
What does that mean?
Well, long ago, when God first made the earth, the air and the water were clean and fresh, and there was enough room for all the animals to live happily. But since that time, people have put dirty things into the air and water, making them bad for the animals to breathe and drink. It's called pollution, and because of it, animals sometimes get sick and die. And if too many of them die, we might not have any more of them left. Just as God depended on Noah to save the animals way back then, he still depends on us to do the same today by taking care of his creation.
Taking care of all the animals in the world.
I think he does it because he loves them so much.
I believe that God above has a special kind of love, more than enough for you and me and all the animals we see. God's love is deep and wide. He's always there, right by our side. In his care we'll always be, all the animals and especially you and me.
I think it's neat that the animals do a lot of the same things we do.
Yeah, like eating, sleeping, and playing.
And don't forget swinging and swaying.
Watching the seals play, and I turned around, and you were gone. I didn't think I'd ever find you guys. I thought I was lost for good.
Isn't it great to know that God always takes care of us, just like he helps me take care of the animals here in the zoo?
When we're awake, or when we're sleeping, God holds us in his safe keeping. When we're lost or all alone, just trust in him to lead us home.
Thank you.
you're glad that I'm in God's care.
Me too. I'm glad that everything God makes is in his care.
God is good. This we know, for the Bible tells us so. Creatures great and creatures small, call him master and lord of all. If we love him, then let's sing praise to God, our maker and king.
Elephants are really going to be hungry if I don't feed them soon. I hope you all had fun today. I sure did. But now it's time to go. The animals need their rest, and so do you.
Oh, not that late.
What a day we've had, filled with so much fun. There was something special for each and every one. Let's say our goodbyes and praise the Lord above. For in all of his creation, we can see his love.
Goodbye, kids. Goodbye, Mother Goose. Thanks for coming. And come back soon. A day for thanking God for them all. A day to laugh, a day to learn, a day for all the creatures great and small.
To do. That's so fun for me and you.